social media is a great democratized engagement platform for people. I mean, you know, it breaks all barriers for people to be able to come and talk about their point of view, to engage with other people in both in learning, in discussing and debate, in just being informed and understanding, inspired. You know, so social media is a good platform for citizens to be able to engage on social issues and on sustainability issues. But there are three ways in which I see this happening. One is that if there is something on the ground, then it can be amplified most effectively on social media. I mean, for example, in Bangalore today, there are over 10,000 people who actually grow their own food in their backyards. And this means something very powerful for food sustainability. So we talk about the whole policy space, we talk about what can be done to make the universal public distribution system more effective. But it's also true that, you know, if we want healthier, chemical-free food, and we should first engage with food, and that can happen in our backyards. And today, such groups are able to come on Facebook, find, you know, people to talk to, find people to practically help them solve their problems, to get them inspired enough to act, and that's the kind of process that we facilitate. Second is that I believe that social media is very effective in bringing together seemingly unrelated people. I mean, when we did recently a Save RTI campaign and a Google Hangout with MP Jai Panda, and there we connected with people from the US, from an Open Data campaigner in London, with our audience, and then bringing to the member of the parliament, his office, and so on, so with RTI activists on the ground. So it's completely sort of citizen empowered, and social media, I think, is a really powerful tool for people from across the world to engage on issues that they care about. And the third thing is that how can we, cutting through all of the noise that which we see today, is also it's an attention economy problem, because we're being bombarded with information. How can people who are bound by common interests, common causes, and so on, and how can we mobilize that interest into action on the ground? So I talked about offline coming online to, online going offline then, because the movement is not made in vaporware. We can mobilize, we can gather together on social media, but I think, and that's great power, but how can we then translate that to what citizens are doing on ground, so that it's a real movement towards sustainability. Social media is a great leveler in terms of everybody has a voice, and everybody's voice it gets counted. There are no filters or barriers, and today there are so many groups that are alternative working on, you know, like there's a peace building group that's working on a dialogue between nations that's based on experiences built on trust, stories of how people have come together on established friendship, established business relations, established, you know, being able to work together on arts and culture and so many different, and even on social development. I mean, you know, people from volunteers from Pakistan or Sri Lanka being able to work on rural grassroots issues in southern Tamil Nadu. That's empowerment. And I think these are the stories that need to come up in social media to then engage these people to say that, you know, this is how we are progressing, and this is the side that you are not knowing more of, you know. And I think that amplifying the voice of these efforts that are happening on the ground is where social media can play a critical role. Let's build an alternative story narrative about all of the work that is inspiring, things that can be replicated, things that people are already working on towards peace building, and tell people that this is possible. This is the possibility with respect to how they can live more sustainably, more inclusively. I think that we are creating a fearless platform for people to be able to talk about their experiences and come out to debate things that they want out of their system, want out of the country, and sharing what they are doing in turn. I think that would be for me the alternative, you know, both in terms of number of people reading us and engaging with us, and everybody taking one action, you know, today towards sustainability. I think that we'd have reached, that's my dream really. In terms of role models, I don't know if I can name one. There are so many people you know, who are who have been doing inspiring. I mean, I just met some local entrepreneurs 2 days ago in northern Karnataka who are doing some fantastic work, right from rainwater harvesting to teaching children, underprivileged children, Hindustani classical music. I mean, the children are playing Gilli Danda while singing ragas in Hindustani classical. Where do you see that kind of a... So I would say that each person that I'm meeting on the ground who is enterprising, who is empowered to think that their life is not about existence but about earning a livelihood and being able to get that effect to multiply across to many, I think is a role model. I'm discovering role models every day.